of this book. I don't know how many free chapters we get for this, so let's go ahead and start chapter 2.
I have your comforter.
Oh, thanks. Oof, oh, you gotta put it on my head?
Yeah.
Why? And you're on my butt. I can't see. I'll put it in the bag later. In a minute. Alright, let's finish up the story. Or at least to the next chapter. That's it.
Finally, remembering the time you smuggled a fortune in diamonds past that dreadfully bearded customs agent. One less tug, one small adjustment there, eminently satisfactory. Not a thread is out of place. You have quite the figure in. Page 3 of One Less Tug, One Small Adjustment There, eminently satisfactory. Not a thread is out of place. You have quite the figure in. A tailored gown and jacket that says quite firmly I am a woman of business. An elegant evening gown with a plunging, yet tasteful, décolletage. A traditional garment reflective of my heritage. An elegant evening gown with a plunging, yet tasteful, décolletage. A tailored gown and jacket that says quite firmly I am a woman of business. An elegant evening gown with a plunging, yet an elegant evening. Next, you shiver with delight at the sensation of the fabric on your skin. It is very fine, and scents of wood and sap through you. The skirts around your ankles crash and foam in a most pleasing way. You can recall if any actual seafoam was spun into the fabric in its making. There's enough fairy skin in the thread that you move easily in the gown, even with your new form still unfamiliar to you, at times. It's good to have something to wear that makes one feel as if one has an ally, particularly as one is about to embark on an evening in Morlok's company. Page, clothing is a reflection of status, of wealth. The right raiment is invaluable in making impressions and cementing opinion. Clothing represents cultural capital, protection from elements that are magical, and in the right hands can be a devastating weapon. Clothing is an expression of power. You are quite pleased with your choice of materials. You can do very well indeed with a fine wool or other such mortal fabric, but you are merchant of the Untermarked. This is an opportunity to showcase your merchandise as much as yourself. And the looms of fairies spin wonders. Kate, you are quite pleased with your choice of materials. Oh, you could do very well indeed with a fine wool or other such mortal fabric, but you are merchant of the Untermarked. This is an opportunity to showcase your merchandise as much as yourself. And the looms of fairies spin wonders. That is not to say that he understated does not have its use. Blending makes each shopping easier, though gaining access to the most interesting of conversations as a participant will be much more difficult. And standing out, while useful socially, makes one easy to track. Woven of Nightmares in the Dark, page 4 of 5. Woven of Nightmares in the Dark, between the stars, the figure I cut evokes terror. Radio button. Checked in fabric of dawn with embroidery threads full of kind words and needed smiles I shine. Parted from stone and strike with steely determination, the cloth crossed my back can turn knives. Wrapped in lover's size and light from long knives, I glimmer and gleam to entice. Mortal the party, so mortal the fabric, I dress as mundane as a mortal the party, so mortal the fabric. Page 5 of 5. Spun silver mind from those dreams that desire weaves makes a most persuasive fashion statement. Mortal the party, so mortal the fabric, I dress mortal the party, so mortal the fabric, I dress as mundane as I may, it's only polite. Page, woven of nightmares in the dark between the skin fabric of dawn with embroidery threads full of kind skin fabric of dawn with embroidery threads full of kind words and needed smiles and shine.
In there, yeah.
Parted from stone and strike with steely determination. Parted from stone and strike with steely determination. The page 5 of mortal the party. So mortal the party. So mortal. Next, the party tonight will be hosted by Lord Profan and Sniffing, known affectionately to those in his affections as those, though few would admit to such familiarity. Lord Profan had taken London by storm some few seasons earlier, debuting in society after extensive travels across the continent. The Smithic fortune perennially attracts a plethora of suitors, both social and business, though upon reflection, there is very little difference between the two kinds of merger, so to speak. Page 2 of 4. This will not be the first of Lord Smithic's affairs you have attended, though it is the first time you've arrived with accompaniment. You allow your attention to flick very briefly to Morlo, beside you. As much as it pains you to admit it, even in the silence of your own mind, that disguise is damnably impressive. In place of the merchant with gold and silver chains for her is a quiet-looking young man, human, and handsome enough to be engaging but not so breathtaking as to stand out in a crowd. He's dressed tastefully, though not quite at the height of fashion, and of a quality that speaks of just enough money for the right circles. It's quite an excellent disguise. Page 4 of 4. In place of the merchant with gold and silver chains for her is a quiet-looking young man, human, and handsome enough to be engaging but not at loving next advertisement. You enter London above the Covent Garden Market. Though shuttered for the night, the air is still haunted by the ghost of the fruits and flowers sold here throughout the day. The the scent of roses whispers salutations to your olfactory senses. Morlock wastes no time but rather hurries you out into the night, moving along the streets toward Lord Profanum's Soho residence. Page 4, you enter London above the Italian Garden Market. Though shuttered for the night, you are still haunted by the ghost of the fruits and flowers. Next button. Though the market itself is quiet, the streets of London are alive. Gangs of squirrels and ne'er-do-wells rove up and down, seeking good food.
Yeah, I probably haven't seen it.
Entertainment of varying degrees of savoriness. Automata in all manner of shapes and sizes gleam richly bronze in the light from windows and lampposts, and in the shadows.
Hey, babe.
The dregs of the city lurk. Entertainment and comfort of the moneyed classes. The tatters and gutters.
Arms support for my.
Scarred veterans of foreign wars. Page 3 of 3. Morlock
tennis elbow, have you?
Though the market itself is Morlock nice through it all.
You know that strap that goes around my arm for tendonitis?
We'll come back to this part in the book.